How does weight affect my reach? Guys, please behave. How does the test work?
We're going to ride for as long as we can on eco mode and see the difference between lightweight, middleweight and heavyweight. See who lasts the longest.
Let's check the scale. Ladies first. Okay, Steffi, 60 kg. Next is Joe with 85 kg. And our heaviest contender, Maurice, with 110 kg. Steffi with her jam squared 9.8. Joe with his focus Sam squared 6.8. Maurice with his jam squared 9.8 drifter. For this experiment, we defined a test track with a mix of technical trails and gravel. Eco mode it is. Let's go.
Okay, 3, 2, 1, go.
Although fun is involved, this is a very serious test. First round done. How long will the batteries last?
Gone. My battery died.
Maurice's battery died first. He's the heaviest guy, it totally makes sense.
Hey man, can you get me a tech pack? I'm done.
Only two riders are left now, light and middleweight. Wait,
finish.
What's that? Joe is empty as well.
Oh god.
See you later.
She's taking the Garmin. She's gonna see how much extra she can get.
So our lightest rider keeps on going. Go Steffi! How far can she go?
Dan.
Do we have some results?
Yeah, 36.8 kilometers. I'm quite stoked.
I got 37.8, 1 kilometer longer.
Two runs more, that's I think maybe 8 kilometers more.
So our biggest learning from this test, riding in a group influences the reach much more than the weight itself. If you adapt to the speed of the slowest in your group, in our case, also the heaviest, you automatically don't push that hard. This means the motor supports more and consumes more energy. That's why the gap between our riders was not as big as their weight difference suggested at the beginning. Despite these results, we highly recommend you ride in a group. If you're lightweight and strong, you might sacrifice a bit of your reach, but nothing outweighs the fun held riding together. For more results, visit the Focus website. Want to see how terrain, mode, and temperature affect your reach? If you do, click here.